session next year. Join Princess Tuptim's play of medicine.
Play cannot succeed with me. It is immoral for King to drown when pursuing a slave. You see? Immoral, immoral! Tuptim shall know of my displeasure.
Your conversation at dinner was most amusing.
I was supposed to laugh myself. I was so funny.
My visit has been most enjoyable. I am certain that Queen Victoria will be pleased.
Ha! See?
I think now, with your Majesty's permission, I should take my leave. Goodbye, Anna, my dear. It's lovely to see you again.
Goodbye, Edward. Well, your Majesty, I do hope you are pleased.
I wish to say you have been a great help to me in this endeavor. I wish to make gift. I have hope you will accept. Well, go on. But don't be there. No.
Your Majesty, I do not know what to say.
When one does not know what to say, it is time to be silent. What do I want? Please stay up all night until we have further report on Tuptim.
I intended to do so, Your Majesty.
Is there something wrong with Tuptim?
I do not know. Nor do I consider this the most important thing. It is of greater importance that the English think highly of me and think me not barbarian.
This is what you intended to prove.
This is what we intended to prove. Tuptim is missing from the palace. You know something of this?
I knew she wasn't happy.
Why unhappy? What greater honor is it for a young girl than to be in palace of king?
Your Majesty, if Tuptim is caught, she should be punished.
Naturally. What would you do if you were king?
Well, I believe I would give her a chance to explain. I would try not to be too harsh. Your Majesty, to what interest to you is one girl like Tuptim? She is just another woman, as a bowl of rice is just another bowl of rice.
Now you understand about women!
Your Majesty, I don't know if I can ever make it clear to you. You do not look on women as just human beings. They are, well, take yourself for instance. You are not just a human male.
I am king!
Exactly. So every man a king and every woman a queen when they love one another.
This is sickly idea.
It's a beautiful idea, Your Majesty. We are brought up with it, of course. But try to imagine a young girl at her first dance. It's very exciting. When you're young and sitting on a small chair, your eyes cast down, terrified that you'll be a wallflower. And suddenly, you see two black shoes, a white waistcoat, a face, and it speaks.
We've just been introduced. I do not know you well, but when the music started, something drew me to your side. So many men and girls, all in each other's arms. It made me think we might be similarly occupied. Shall we dance on a bright cloud of music? Shall we fly? Shall we dance? Shall we then say goodnight and mean goodbye? Or perchance, when the last mental star has left the sky, shall we still be together with our arms around each other? And shall you be my new romance? On the clear understanding that this kind of thing can happen, shall we dance? Shall we dance? Shall we dance?
Holding hands, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
Well, always a
us friend. Good. You show me. Deets, deets, deets.
It's very simple, the polka.
Bye.